thank you, Jesus. We're so grateful. Thank you for your service.
Amen.
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 Hey, we're so glad again to be in the Lord's house and to hear a word from him today. I'm thankful to God for allowing me to be here to share with you.
Amen.
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 What I love today is that I begin a new series of sermons, and I like to preach series of sermons. Amen.
All
right. Mm-hmm. The reason I preach series of sermons is that it keeps us on track, keeps us following, keeps continuity among the sermons. So today I want to begin a new series on how to be an excellent church. We've been talking about this concept, this idea of excellence and striving for excellence. Today I'm going to share with us how to be an excellent church. How to be an excellent church. And the best way to learn how to be an excellent church is to learn from a church.
All right.
A church that was excellent.
All right.
Have we got a witness?
Amen.
Not just any kind of church, but the first century church, the first church that was established. It was an excellent church.
Amen.
As you look at the text today, this church excelled in four different areas.
All right.
Today, my subject today is an excellent church focuses on membership. Amen. An excellent church focuses on membership.
Yeah.
Now, not necessarily numbers. Amen. I'm not talking about numbers. Amen.
All right.
Because God makes numbers count.
Yeah.
He doesn't count numbers. Have we got a witness?
Amen.
We've been discovering that in our Bible studies, we discovered that in 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 7, that we have, as a body of believers, we have inside of us what it takes to become excellent church.
Amen.
Do I have a witness? The text says, but we have this treasure in earthen vessels that the excellency of the power may be of God and not of us.
Right.
And so God has placed his presence on the inside of us
that
allows us to accomplish and to become whatever God wants to be.
Amen.
The word really says that we can be an excellent church.
Amen.
Amen. I said this on Wednesday night, there's no such word anymore as I can. Amen.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because the Bible says, I can do all. Oh, she had a few witnesses in here. They just said, I can do something. He said, I can do all things. And all the way through the fact that I can become and we can become an excellent church.
Yeah.
Is that anybody get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
We can become an excellent church.
Yeah.
So today I want to share with you that an excellent church, amen, an excellent church focuses on membership. In our context, there had been a spirit-filled revival that took place, and Peter was the preacher.
Yeah.
The Bible declared that after Peter began preaching, 3,000 souls were saved. They gave their life to the Lord.
Yeah.
And I want to share with you, they didn't stop there.
All right.
They didn't do like we did.
Come on.
We do sometimes. Have we got a witness?
Amen.
I'm saved, that's it.
I'm
going to do like a sponge. I'm going to sit down and soak it in. I'm not going to get squeezed out. I wish I had a witness in there. The first church was established and it was founded. Have we got a witness? On steadfastness. It didn't stop. The Bible said it continued.
Amen.
Did y'all see that in verse 2 of our text? It says, and they continued what? Steadfastly in the apostles' what? Doctrine. Can I just walk right there? And say that membership continuing in Christian education.
All right.
We don't ever want to stop learning.
Amen.
Amen. That's how we become an excellent church. That's how you become an excellent family. You become an excellent body, an excellent person. Is you continue to study the Word of God.
Amen.
I wish I had a witness today.
Yes,
I was talking to a young man just last week on a field trip, and he was talking about the fact that the Bible was written by man. I said, yes, it was written by man under the direction and the unction and the guidance of the Holy Spirit of God. The Bible itself has said it was given by inspiration. It was given by inspiration of God. Now, I said, if you can believe any other material written by man, why can't you believe the Word of God? I know why we don't want to believe the Word of God, because the Word causes a change of faith.
Walk
calls you to get outside of your comfort zone. Strive for excellence will cause you to get outside of your comfort zone. Amen. It says, and they continued steadfastly in the what? Apostles' doctrine. Membership is more than getting your name on the roll.
Yeah.
I say it's more than getting your name on the roll. You've been called out by God. You've been set apart. You've been sanctified. You've been filled with the Holy Ghost. You've been filled with the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit does not sit down.
Amen.
Hey, I know y'all gonna get angry with me a little bit. Membership is more than just having your name. You see, folks will go to they'll go to church just to get their name on the roll. Amen. It's, the question is your name written on the Lamb's book? Is your name personal challenges.